ಗಣೇಶಾಯ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಸರಸ್ವತ್ಯೈ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಸಮಸ್ತ ಜನ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣೇ ನಿರತಂ ಕರುಣಾಮಯಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಚಿನ್ಮಯಂ ದೇವಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವಿದ್ವರಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವಿದ್ವರಂ ಓಂ ಶುಕ್ಲಾಂಬರಧರಂ ವಿಷ್ಣುಂ ಶಶಿವರ್ಣಂ ಚತುರ್ಭುಜಂ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನವದನಂ ಧ್ಯಾಯೇತ್ ಸರ್ವವಿಘ್ನೋಪಶಾಂತಯೇ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ವಸಿಷ್ಠನಕ್ತಾರಂ ಶಕ್ತೇ ಪೌತ್ರಮಕಲ್ಮಷಂ ಪರಾಶರಾತ್ಮಜಂ ವಂದೇ ಶುಕತಾತಂ ತಪೋನಿಧಿಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣುರೂಪಾಯ ವ್ಯಾಸರೂಪಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣವೇ ನಮೋ ವೈ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನಿಧಯೇ ವಾಸಿಷ್ಠಾಯ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ ವಸುದೇವಸುತಂ ದೇವಂ ಕಂಸಚಾಣೂರಮರ್ದನಂ ದೇವಕೀ ಪರಮಾನಂದಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ. ಓಂ ನಾರಾಯಣಂ ನಮಸ್ಕೃತ್ಯ ನರಂ ಚೈವ ನರೋತ್ತಮಂ ದೇವೀಂ ಸರಸ್ವತೀಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ತತೋ ಜಯಮುದೀರಯೇತ್. ಓಂ ನಮೋ ವಸಿಷ್ಠಾಯ ಮಹಾವ್ರತಾಯ ಪರಾಶರಂ ವೇದನಿಧಿಂ ನಮಸ್ಯೇ. ನಮೋಸ್ತ್ವನಂತಾಯ ಮಹೋರಗಾಯ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ಸಿದ್ಧೇಭ್ಯಕ್ಷಯೇಭ್ಯಃ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ಋಷಿಭ್ಯ ಪರಮಂ ಪರೇಷಾಂ ದೇವೇಶು ದೇವಂ ವರದಂ ವರಾಣಾಂ ಸಹಸ್ರಶೀರ್ಷಾಯ ನಮಃ ಶಿವಾಯ ಸಹಸ್ರನಾಮಾಯ ಜನಾರ್ದನಾಯ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ಟುಡೇ ದ್ರೋಣ ಪರ್ವ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಸಾ ಹೌ ಫೆರೋಷಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಭೀಷ್ಮಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಫಾಟ್ ದ ವಾರ್ for the first 10 days and how the war went on and what an amount of destruction took place in that war and description of the war day by day, who were killed in first 10 days and also the description of Rana Nadi in the Bhishma Parva and the fall of Bhishmacharya and his appeal to all the kings to withdraw now, stop the war, but of course nobody heard. And Karṇa's secret meeting with Bhishmacharya, so Bhishmacharya telling the reason why he is to put him low in the court always, so all those things we saw and how Bhishmacharya took sankalpa to hold on to that physical body for some time and till Uttarayana Punyakala and then how he leaves. Now after which the Drona Parva, it begins with a question from Janamejaya. So Janamejaya asked a question, O Brahman, to whom? Janamejaya asked to Vaishampayan Rishi. So Vaishampayana ko pooch rahe the, pooch Vaishampayana se, Janamejaya ko vacha, O Brahmana, O Brahman, Dhritarashtra, after the war and the 10 days of war, Bhishmacharya's fall, would have profusely cried, no, listening to the death of Bhishmacharya. What did he do after the death of Bhishmacharya? Unhone kya kiya iske baad mein? Then Duryodhana, etc. also, all those battalion, had tried maximum to loot the whole kingdom of Pandavas also. But what did Duryodhana do after the death of Bhishmacharya? Though he tried maximum to loot the plunder all the kingdom, but Bhishmacharya also now left. So please tell me all those things in detail, what all happened, the events, how they are unpacked or rolled out. They were rolled out. Vaishampayana said, Dhritarashtra was drowned. Vaishampayana continued, he says, he was totally submerged in the ocean of sorrow and he could not get peace of mind even for a moment. That was his condition at that time. So again he spoke to Sanjaya. So iske baad mein yuddh ho gaya kuch din, then Sanjaya would have gone back, again came out. All those things, of course, not mentioned here. So Dhritarashtra said, to ask Sanjaya, now what did Kauravas do after the fall of Bhishmacharya? And Sanjaya, this Bhishmacharya's fall, that is not it died, but then fell down. It would have created a terrible fear in the hearts of the people, all the kings. So, especially Kauravas, they were extremely scared of these things. Now tell me, whom did they approach for help at that time? Kauravas. And what did the rest of the kings do after the fall of Bhishmacharya? Baki sara log kya kya kiye the? Ye sab cheeze humko tik tik se aap samjhaiyega. Then Sanjaya vacha. Then Sanjaya said, both Pandavas and Kauravas, both of them felt deeply, you know, affected sorrow in their hearts. Both of them, that is Pandava forces as well as Kaurava forces, recalled Kshatriya dharma, Kshatra dharma ko man mein phir smaran karke, then they became shant, peaceful in their hearts. Mane, some kind of peace was brought into their hearts by themselves by remembering Kshatra dharma. What is the Kshatra dharma? Look, Kshatra dharma is a hota hai. It is what is the Kshatra dharma is. Fight for the war and be ready to die. Karke, this is how the world is. Karke, they made themselves somehow consoled their hearts. Then they made all the arrangements for Bhishmacharya, all arrangements for his stay, put a tent there, and after doing parikrama around Bhishmacharya ji, and they again left for their tents and of course subsequently for the war. So they left for the war. Last match, Bhishmacharya, we concluded, we said that they all left for their tents only to collect their weapons again to go to the war field. Even though Bhishmacharya ji had appealed to all the kings for peace, but O Raja, they did not hear to the words of those great wise men. Who said this? Dhritarashtra was speaking. So Sanjaya answered. So due to your attachment, Sanjaya is asked, telling to Dhritarashtra only, due to your own attachment towards his children, that is towards your children, as well as the fall of Bhishmacharya, all the Kauravas became or came under the grip of Mrityu. Mrityu Devata, Mrityu mein phas gaye sab log. Kyunki do hi karan hai. Pehla karan kya tha? Aapka apne putron ke prati mamata. Dusra kya karan hai? Fall of Bhishmacharya. So yehi do hi karan hai. And all your sons were extremely agitated in their minds, because without Bhishmacharya, they could not even think of their protector. Now, who could be their protector now? Who is their leader? So they were agitated, and when the war about to start also, but troubled by Pandavas, who did not compromise in achieving their goals. Who are Pandavas? They didn't compromise. They were uncompromisingly fighting. In fact, we were read also, when Bhishmacharya fell down, Kauravas were all dumbfounded and then they didn't know what to do. But Pandava side celebrated, and Bhima also danced at the fall of Bhishmacharya. So they were uncompromisingly holding on to their goals. So all your sons were trapped in the tragedies like a boat captivated and thrown by the heavy winds on the high seas. Like that, all your sons were trapped at that time. And when the war is about to start, started also, they all have lost heavily already, of course, in 10 days their forces, and they are slowly sinking into their nether regions. Means, dheere 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 neeche girte ja rahe. At that crucial time, they remembered Karna. First 10 days he was not there. So, because they thought Karna was equal to Bhishma himself. All Kauravas thought that. So the shouts heard all over the world, all over the battlefield from among Kaurava side. Sab log ye suna, call him immediately. Unko jaldi bulao, Karna ko bulao, and don't delay further. He did not fight for 10 days now. 10 days, 10 din to kaam yuddha nahi kiya. So that everybody, Karna kaha hai, Karna ko bulao ye. Karke those screams were heard. So they all called him and said, so Karna, now we need your help, Kaurava said. So please help with your valor, your parakram, prowess. So when Sanjaya thus mentioning Karna's name bar bar, you know, Sanjaya was mentioning Karna's name bar bar, that they all shouted for Karṇa. They all wanted for the Karṇa only to join them. They believed that Karṇa is capable. They believed that some of them believed that Karṇa is equal to Bhishmacharya himself. So Karṇa is our friend now. He will eliminate Pandavas. It's like that they were bar bar Karṇa ka naam lete ja rahe hai. Then Dhritarashtra, when Sanjay was taking repeatedly Karṇa's name, so Dhritarashtra asked him again, Sanjaya, bar bar to Karṇa ka naam le rahe hai. But did you see Karṇa there at that time? Anxiety now came. Whether Karṇa was there or not, Karṇa helped. Kya hua? Huh? When all of you were calling him, sab log pukar rahe the unke liye, kya wo wahi pe the kya? Kahan the wo? I hope I did not turn away your request. Bole nahi diya beech mein. Wo kahani sunte ho, abhi aage bolo, jaldi kya hua? Wo mana ki nahi request. I hope he did not turn the request. Has he fulfilled the gap created by the fall of Bhishmacharya? Well, Sanjay was telling and he was not allowed to tell. Suddenly Dhritarashtra's anxiety came out. Had he fulfilled? And they filled the gap also created by Bhishmacharya's fall? Could he create fear in the enemies? What did he do in the war? Please tell me all details without any further delay. So Sanjay has continued. Before I forget, there are 202 chapters in Drona Parva. Okay? So, आप सोचते होंगे कि महाभारत खत्म नहीं होगा क्या जीवन में? ठीक, चलो आपको खुशी के लिए मैं एक बात बोल देता हूँ. This is the last volume we have to study. ठीक है, खुश हो गए? Out of 6 we completed 5 volumes of study. Anyway, so it's 202 chapters, but then we can skip all the war details. Let us see how Bhagavan Vyasji guide us. So Sanjaya says, realizing that the entire Kuru forces are drowned in sorrow after the fall of Bhishmacharya, Karṇa went to them to rescue them all from their troubles like a elder brother. Sanjaya says, he went straight to Duryodhana in a very hurriedly, he went, rushed to Duryodhana like a father to console and offer protection to him. He took all his weapons. Remember, Karṇa knew that he is a son of Kunti. He refused that all that Kunti's requests. So many things we saw. And when Bhagavan Krishna asked him to join Pandava, he said no. First 10 days you will be fight on the side of Pandavas. He said no. I mean, first of all, till Bhishmacharya is alive. He said no. All those things. He said no. So Bhishma, Karṇa knew. So he rushed to him, the Pandava Kaurava side, as an elder brother, and also like a father, he went to Duryodhana and offered protection. And while he was going to warfield, he took with him all the weapons given by Parashuramji. Divyastra. Divyastra te unke paas, saare chizun ko leke gaye. And with the fall of Bhishmacharya, he said now, I am now in the field. Abhi is vakt mein ranabhume hoon, kade hoon. And I feel the enemies have already been conquered by me in the war. Ye Karṇa ka ek bada bimari kya hai pata hai? Overconfidence. Throughout Mahabharata, we come across this Karṇa's character. Karṇa is always overconfident. So, I feel when I'm standing here, I feel enemies have already been conquered. And he says, it is a fact that nothing remains permanent in the creation. With the fall of Bhishma himself, we have to say without any doubt that whether there will be sunrise tomorrow or not. Mane Bhishmacharya jaise mahan vyakti bhi gir gaye, to humme koi bhi vyakti aisa keh nahi sakta ki kal suryodaya hoga ki nahi hoga. Mane hum jeevit rahenge ki nahi, ye koi bata na sakte. That is the meaning. Who will see sunrise tomorrow? We don't. Like Bhishmacharya himself felt also. Karṇa knew the uncertainty, and he is talking little philosophy. Nothing remains permanent. So therefore, Bhishma, he says, Bhishma had brilliance of what you call Vasudevatas. He was born to Shantanu. He was like Vasudevata himself on earth. Bhishma had now attained Vasuloka only. Hence, you all wail now for your own families in the absence of Bhishmacharya. आप यदि रोना है तो आप अपने लिए, परिवार के लिए रो, क्योंकि भरोसा नहीं है हम कब मरेंगे कब जिएंगे. Wail for the people of Kuru and also the army of Kauravas now, because there is no Bhishmacharya to protect them. And listening to Karna's feelings, you know, आप रोना है तो आप अपने परिवार के लिए रो लिए एक बार, क्योंकि ना भीष्माचार्य खुद ही गिर गए हैं, पता नहीं आप हम और सब जीवित रहेंगे कि नहीं। सो कर्णा स्पीकिंग एंड कर्णा आउट ऑफ दुख ओनली, सो लिसनिंग टू कर्णास फीलिंग्स ऑल द कौरवास ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड क्राइंग, शेड देयर टीयर्स एंड व्हेन द वॉर हैड स्टार्टेड एंड पांडवास फॉर किलिंग कौरवास इन ह्यूज नंबर्स ऑन 11th डे। सो कर्णा लुक्ड एट दिस एंड ही स्पोक टू कौरवा, सबको इंस्पिरेशन स्फूर्ति देते हुए कहा कि सेड आई एम अनेबल टू सी एनी परमानेंट वस्तु इन दिस एफिमेरल क्रिएशन, इम्परमानेंट जगत में आई एम अनेबल टू सी हाउ कैन यू सी परमानेंट वस्तु इन इम्परमानेंट जगत, बट फिलोसफी इज कमिंग आउट विच मूव्स ऑलवेज टुवर्ड्स डेथ। आई एम अनेबल टू सी कोई भी ऐसा वस्तु मैंने देख पा रहा हूँ कि, क्योंकि सारे के सारा चीज एवरीथिंग इज गशिंग टुवर्ड्स मृत्यु, अदरवाइज how is it possible that Bhishmacharya had fallen in the battleground while all of you were very much alive? He was asking Kauravas, aap sabhi log jeete hue, how is it possible that Bhishmacharya fell down? With his fall, he says his fall is like the fall of Surya Devata, Surya Graha or Surya Mandalam or Surya orbit of Surya himself on the earth from its place, as Surya Bhagwan gir jata hai prithvi par, similarly it is like sun falling on the earth, like Bhishmacharya fell down. With his fall, all the hosts of these kings now will not be able to withstand Arjuna's force. How? Like an ordinary trees on a mountain cannot withstand heavy winds. They can't withstand. Now all these Kaurava kings cannot withstand Arjuna's force. Who is telling this? Karna is telling this. Today, Kauravas are like orphans. He was crying and wailing and expressing his sadness. Like orphans, anath jaise hai, having lost all their inspiration today. And I must protect this Kaurava force like how Bhishma had protected it before. So Maniman sochila ki now I have to protect this Kaurava force like Bhishma protected before, I must now. So why should I fear now? When I know that whole creation is ephemeral and even a person like Bhishma fell down, ab main kis cheez se, kis vyakti se daru main? Bhishmacharya khud gir gaya. So either I punish the enemies today with my arrows or get killed in the war and attain swarga or heaven. So he says, Yudhishthira ke bare mein keh rahe the, Yudhishthira has patience, wisdom, truthfulness and also he endowed with sattva guna. Bhima had strength of thousands of elephants. Arjuna is none other than son of Indra and is also very young also now. Hence, it is not possible to win wind of Pandavas even by all the gods put together. So no one can escape death when he enters into the mouth of enemies where Bhagavan Krishna and Sartaki are present. Jahan pe jis paksh mein Bhagavan Krishna aur Sartaki khade hai, wahan pe koi bhi vyakti bach nahi sakta, apne aap ko bacha nahi sakta. When afterwards, after entering into the war zone and after facing Bhagavan Krishna aur Sartaki, like a murchu mukha only, nobody can escape. And Karna says all this. So in this way he addressed his charioteer. फिर उनको रथ सारथी से बोला कि ओ सूता, today I will conquer all the enemies without any fear. How can I ignore someone who inflicted pain to my friends? Because my friends are Duryodhana, Kauravas and all. And somebody inflicted a lot of pain on them. How can I ignore them? So he alone is the friend who stands by the side even in terrible times. I think आज मेरा मित्र धर्म जो है प्रकट करना ही पड़ेगा. In this way many things he spoke to his charioteer and concluded in the end that he cannot keep quiet when his friends are in trouble. Okay, that ultimate afterward long thing and avoiding all the portion. So what he said, he will, what do you call, Karna said, I cannot tolerate. So he will fight for, now he says, I will fight for the sake, I cannot deceive my friends. That was Karna's point. I cannot deceive my friends now. So let us go and fight. Saying this, Sanjaya says, Oh Maharaja, Karna had left for the war with his best of his chariots, horses, carrying divine weapons, etc., etc., as procured from Parashuramji. Now, Sanjaya Vacha continued, another chapter. Bhishma, he was sleeping on the bed of arrows. And when he was sleeping, he was looking like a Mainak Parvat on earth, thrown by Bhagavan, I mean Indra himself. Or he was like looking like sun fallen on earth from the sky. So much brilliance, shining. Like a, hum bolte chand ki tukda, but actually we never talk about भगवान सूर्य भगवान की टुकड़ा पृथ्वी पर, चांद की टुकड़ा बोलते हैं सूर्य भगवान, बट यहाँ पे ऐसे कह रहे हैं लाइक सन हिमसेल्फ हैज फॉलन ऑन अर्थ. सो देन Karṇa went to see him to take Bhishmacharya's blessings again. And he goes before the war. He saw Bhishmacharya in that condition and he could not control. Tears came out. Then he spoke to Bhishmacharya. Oh Bharata, I am Karṇa. Please speak few words to me. Jyada nahi bolna hai. Through your pure and auspicious mouth and look at me with your graceful eyes. I love you and respect you. Karṇa respects. So look at me with your graceful looks or eyes, with your pure and auspicious mouth. You speak few words to me. It is for sure that no one would enjoy their punya karma phala in this earth. Abhi ye nischay ho gaya ki punya karma hum jo karte hain, iska phal is prithvi par koi bhi nahi bhogta. Kyun? That is our feeling. Otherwise, why should you suffer like this? The very fact that you are suffering on earth, sleeping on bed of arrows, indicate that all your punya karma, so much punya you have done, what happened to all punya karma? Iska matlab yahi nikla ki punya karma is feeling, it is not that punya karma you don't enjoy here. Jo punya karma, that for example, if you go to Australia, you have to use Australian dollars, that exchange money, whatever exchange. Jitna paisa exchange kiya, wo paisa aap leke jayenge, utna bhog ke aa jayenge aap. Similarly, our punya, which is valid only on earth, for that bhoga we have to come back to prithvi. Some punya we have done for which we have to enjoy only in higher worlds. To uske liye kya karna hai? Uske liye hum dusra lok mein jaake baithna hai. Theek hai? So therefore, here he says that it is for sure. आपको देखने के बाद ऐसा लगता है कि सबका पुण्य कर्म जो है, आई थिंक वी हैव टू एंजॉय ओनली इन अदर लोकस, अदरवाइज वाई विल यू बी इन दिस स्टेट टूडे? एब्सोल्यूटली. सो यू हैव लिव्ड धर्म ऑल यूर लाइफ एंड यू डोंट डिजर्व दिस स्टेट एट ऑल, बट स्टिल यू आर लाइंग डाउन इन दिस कंडीशन. ओ भीष्म पितामह, हमको ऐसा लगता है. सो देयरफॉर देयर इज नो वन लाइक यू अमोंग द कौरवास इन एक्वायरिंग वेल्थ. कुरुकुल में जैसे भीष्माचार्य का धन का संपत्ति नो धन कमाया बाय वेजिंग वॉर्स एंड कंट्रोलिंग किंग्स एटसेट्रा, नोबडी वाज देयर. एंड आल्सो काउंसलिंग वेरियस किंग्स, सो ऑफरिंग सॉल्यूशंस टू प्रॉब्लम्स, द ग्रेट 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 पॉलिटिशियन ही वाज, एंड अरेंज द फोर्सेस, व्यूह रचना, हाउ टू अरे द फोर्सेस इन द बैटल, नोबडी. एंड इन अटैकिंग एनिमीज विद वेराइटीज ऑफ वेपन्स, हु इज देयर टू इक्वेट टू भीष्माचार्य? So there is nobody like you who can bail out now the Kauravas from their fear. Today, all the Kaurava forces, they would get highly scared by Arjuna's Gandiva. Main aapse keh raha hu Bhishmacharya ji, wo pitamaha, that Arjuna Gandiva ko dekhte hi sare Kaurava log abhi darr se tar baithe, bas uthe ke baithe. And the arrows released from his Gandiva bow, he would scare all the kings. And the flames of Arjuna's arrows, it would surely burn all the Kaurava forces. The twangs of Gandiva would create tremor in the hearts of the Kauravas. The blow of the conch and the twangs of Gandiva, it would cause immense fear to Kaurava forces. They cannot bear the crackling sounds of the chariot of Arjuna. So who can win Arjuna in the battle? Even you could not conquer him in the battle, O Bhishma Pitamaha. Bhishma ji, aap swayam khud yuddh lad rahe the. Even you could not conquer Arjuna. But today, if your blessings and permission is there, I will go and defeat Arjuna in the war. So please, please, please bless me so that I will, with your blessings, I am capable of killing Pandavas or defeating Pandavas in the war. So I am going to wage a war with them. So kindly bless me. Please bless me. Please bless me. So Sanjaya Vacha. So Sanjaya said, Bhishma, he heard Karna's talk and with peaceful mind and graceful looks, he addressed Karna. No anger, that very peaceful he was. He said, Bhishmacharya said, Karna, just as a ocean is a shelter for all the rivers, Just as sun is a source for all illumining objects, just as a fertile land is a shelter for all the seeds, just as the clouds is a shelter for all the living beings for food, similarly, you also become a great shelter to all your friends. Just as the devatas live taking support of Indra, similarly, let all your friends and relatives live taking your support. That is what he said. So you become the scorcher of your enemies, bestower of happiness to all your friends. Aap, you know, shatruon ke liye bhaydayak aur apne mitron ke liye aashirvad ke roop mein sukh pradata bano. Just as Bhagavan Vishnu is a support to all the devatas, similarly, O Karṇa, today you go, because I am now lying down in this condition. You go and you become a great support to all the Kauravas now. So earlier, you had mentioned Kambojas, conquered. Isse pehle tum apne jeevan mein, you have conquered Kambojas, Gandhara kings, Kiratakas, Utkala, Mekala, Paundra, Kalinga, Andhra, Nishada, Trigartha, and Bahlika, etc. All those Rajas and soldiers were defeated by you. Just as Duryodhana is a great source of help for all the Kauravas, similarly, you become a great shelter to all Kauravas today. And he says, Bhishmacharya, blessing Karṇa. And he said, friendship made with good people is far superior to the relationship with the family members. Because your relationship with Duryodhana, accepting Duryodhana as your friend, is far, far, far superior to the family members. That means your Maitri is standing superior to any other thing, any other relationship. So becoming a true friend today and considering all this is mine only, yes, sab hamara mera hi hai, ownership. So Bhishmacharya is teaching Karṇa ownership. Become an owner, owner of your own, the entire force, Kaurava forces. You feel that you are the owner of these forces and you protect the Kauravas as Duryodhana would protect with all his commitment and love. So you go and protect them. So aisa Bhishmacharya spoke to Karṇa. And then ultimately, after speaking to him like this, Karṇa was happy. He offered his salutations at his feet and left for the Yuddha Bhumi. Seeing him joining the war, Duryodhana and also Duśāsana, Kauravas, all other warriors got excited in joy. Hey, Karṇa agaya, Karṇa agaya, Karṇa agaya. And they all welcomed him in the war field, battlefield. So, Duryodhana, Sanjay continues. Then Duryodhana, afterwards, when Karṇa joined, he spoke to Karṇa. Unko ratha bithaya. Yuddha shuru ho raha tha. So, when Karṇa joined Duryodhana, so Sanjaya says, all Kauravas were very excited to see Karṇa. And at that time, Duryodhana said, Karṇa, now abhi mai sanath ho gaya, abhi tak anath raha. Between, after Bhishmacharya's death, I was an orphan, like nobody to protect me, support me. Ab now I got a nath, a master, a supporter. So, by you and with help of your help, I mean with your help, I feel that the whole army of Kaurava army is protected now. So now you decide what is good for us. Ab hume kya karna hai aage? Aapko dekhne ke baad itna khushi hui, pucho mat. So you tell me now what is to be done. So Karṇa said, Duryodhana, you are very wise person. So first you speak your mind. Abhi is yuddha mein, 11th day we are about to start. Tell me now what is in your mind. So as a owner, you know, jaisa malik sochta hai na, waisa aur koi nahi soch sakta. So you are owner of this kingdom. So just as the owner of the wealth, wealthy owner or owner of a entrepreneur or wealth thinks, others cannot think like the owner. Therefore, we may not be able to think from your point of view. So please, we are all very eager to listen to you first, O Duryodhana. So my dear friend, you speak your mind first. What is in your mind? How do you want us to go now in the war? So Duryodhana said, isse pehle Bhishmacharya was our commandant in chief, Senapati Raha. And he protected all our Kaurava forces for 10 days. Now he is on his way to Swargaloka.
So whom do you think now, O Karṇa, tell me, is fit enough now to become a senapati, commandant in chief now? Because just as a captainless ship cannot have any destination, it can't reach any destination, similarly, without a commandant, we also cannot progress. So just as without a guide, Margadarshak beach mein, Marg ke beach mein, a troop or a group of people cannot, or travelers cannot reach the destination without a guide. They'll immediately stop, instantly they would halt their journey. Similarly, without a senapati, we cannot function now. So therefore, whomever you suggest, we will select him as our commandant in chief without any doubt. You please decide now whom to select. Whatever you suggest, that will be accepted. So Karṇa said, so beautiful. Here the leadership, how a leader was selected. Simple 2-3 points only, I am not analyzing. So all the Karṇa said now, yahan pe jitne bhi raja log hai abhi, all the kings who are assembled here, all of them without any exception are capable of leading us as commandants, senapatis. There is no doubt about it. They are all wise, strong, knowledgeable, and also capable leaders. Who? All the people. So they will never turn away from the battlefield. This is the characteristics of our kings now who are there. They all have good qualities. Now, therefore, there is no doubt that we have so many forces with us who are capable of becoming leaders. But all of them cannot be made senapatis at one time. So that is why the one in whom all these special qualities, special abilities are seen fully, he should be selected as a commandant or commandant in chief or senapati. Sab mein achhe gun hai, but jisme ye sare gun maximum, no, who is having holding all these gunas. So such a person should be selected as commandant now. However, all these rajas now, the problem with all of them is they hold competitive thought against each other. If you make somebody as senapati, all the others would feel sad, and in their minds they would decide that they will not fight for your good. Gussa mein, they may not fight for your good. So they are not genuine, because everybody has that spardha towards others. So Dronacharya, aap dekh lijiye unko, he is the oldest among all the warriors. He is our guru also. Moreover, he is the best among the Shrestha, wielders of the weapons. Best among the wielders of the weapons. Shastradhariyo mein ati Shrestha hai. So Acharya Drona alone, he has right to become Senapati. So leaving him aside, who can become Senapati now? Nobody. If you set Bhishmacharya and Dronacharya aside, who is capable of becoming Senapati now? There is not a single warrior who doesn't like to follow the footsteps of Dronacharya. Everybody in the king are willing to follow the direction shown by Dronacharya unconditionally. Therefore, O Duryodhana, you make Acharya Drona now as our next commandant in chief. So this is only capable now. Dekh lo, aap unhi ko banaiyega. Having said this, then Sanjayo vacha. Sanjay said, continued. Duryodhana, what did he do? He, having heard Karna's speech or suggestions, then he went to Dronacharya and spoke to him. So Dronacharya said, Duryodhana said, O Dvijasreshtha, best among the twice born, you are of high varna, Brahmana varna, very intelligent. You were born in Uttamakula. You are a tapasvi. You are above all of us in knowledge of the scriptures. You are in your position also, you are all above all of us. You are intelligent. You are valorous. In tact also, you are very high above us. Invincibility, also in arthajnana, policy, niti, in victory, penance, gratitude, all these good qualities, you are far, 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 far above us. Therefore, there is nobody like you among all these kings. So, O sinless one, now I am keeping all my army in your hands. Please array our forces, ab vyuhrachan banaiye, and destroy the enemies as Indra destroyed Daityas. They say, ab visvindarli, you also kill all these enemies now. I am sure Arjuna, who has Gandiva with him, he will not strike against you. Because his Acharya ke prati, Arjuna declared in the Mahabharatam that I will not fight against Dronacharya. I will not kill him. He is my guru and I will not do. So Dushtajumna is meant for it. So similarly he said, Duryodhana says now, so Arjuna also will not come and fight with you against you. So as soon as he listens to the tanks of your bow, he will go away. He will not fight with you. If you agree and you become our Senapati, then it is for sure that I will defeat Yudhishthira. Why? Arjuna will not fight with you. So you are capable of fighting anybody with anybody. Arjuna will be difficult to conquer. Bhishmacharya could not conquer. So all others can be easily defeated. So listening to these words of Duryodhana, all the warriors, rest of the kings, Kaurava people, they shouted, victory to Dronacharya. Hail to Dronacharya. Hail Dronacharya. Victory to Dronacharya. Dronacharya ki jai ho, jai ho, jai ho. So everybody got inspiration looking at Dronacharya as their new commandant in chief, Senapati. So that's how the Senapati was selected. So as soon as it was done, Dronacharya said, spoke. Dronacharya said, I know Vedas, all Vedas with Vedangas. Vedangas means Shiksha, Vyakarana, Kalpa, Nirukta, Jyotisha, Chandas, etc. Arthashastra given by Manu, I know thoroughly. I also learned Banavidya, that is arrows, Banavidya given by Bhagavan Shankara, Lord Shankara himself, Banavidya. And also I studied many, many other texts now. Whatever qualities that you have hailed in me now, you praised me that I am, you are so and so, you are so and so, to make them all real, because you praised me, I will fight with Pandavas. Achha, sab sare cheez apne sach karke dikhane ke liye main Pandavon ke saath ladai ya yuddha karunga. To Raja, but I will not kill Dushtajumna in the war at any cost. Why? Because he was born only to kill me. It is already decided. So my unke saath yuddha karna kyun karun abhi? Because Shankara, Lord Shiva gave a boon. He is meant to kill me only. So why should I fight with Dhrushtajumna? I will postpone. Within brackets I am talking. So I will not fight with Dhrushtajumna. But I will fight with Pandava forces. Killing, like Bhishmacharya said, I will not fight with Shikhandi. I will not kill Pandavas. Pandavas are not capable of, I mean, it is not possible to kill Pandavas. I will not fight with Shikhandi. So the Dronacharya condition is, I will not fight with Dhrushtajumna. So I will fight with the rest of the Pandavas, Pandava forces, killing all the Somakas in the war. But remember, this Yudhime, Pandavas will not face me wholeheartedly in the war. That I know. I am their guru. So when they fight with me, that Guru Bhav ajata hai. So they, that Gussa, that kind of valor, Parakram, it won't express. So Sanjaya said, thus Dronacharya spoke. So Duryodhana, there afterwards, performed the ritual and installed Dronacharya as commandant in chief of Kaurava forces. Here, after installing Dronacharya by Vedic rituals, etc., then and there only in the battlefield, then Kauravas concluded, at that time they all felt that they had already conquered Pandavas. Chalo, Dronacharya aa gaya, iska matlab hum jeeti gaye samjho. Only matter of time. Dronacharya, he got ready for the war along with his son Ashwatthama. Chalo, ready ho gaya. Yahan pe Jayadratha, king of Kalinga, Vikarna, Shakuni along with other kings of Gandhara Desha, Krupacharya, Krutavarma, Vivimshati, Dushasana, Sudakshina, soldiers of Kambhoja Rajya, and also with Yavanas, Madra, Trigartha, Ambashta, Pratichya, Udichya, etc. All those Rajas took different positions very strategically, protecting Dronacharya. Earlier, Duryodhana said, Bhishma Mevadi Rakshantu. Now the strategy is Dronacharya to be supported in the war. He should be protected. So that his right wheel protector, left wheel protector, peeche se raksha karne wale, aage se raksha karne wale, all these kings divided and took their positions. And after seeing Karṇa, Kaurava warrior, Sanjay ji says, Karṇa ko dekhne ke baad, sare yodhaon ye bhul gaye ki Bhishmacharya nahi hai humare sab beech mein. That they forgot. That is, all of them became freed from all their sorrow. That Bhishmacharya humare beech mein nahi hai. That thought completely they forgot after looking at Karṇa. They felt that Karṇa replaced Bhishmacharya. So that some gap is filled. That lacuna is not felt. So they talked among themselves. Sabhi Raja log na aapas baat karne lag gaye. All other warriors. Kya hai na? Bhishmacharya to 10 din Pandavon ki raksha ki. Thik se yudh nahi kiya Pandavon ke saath. Though it was not a fact. So, he protected Pandavas without killing them. Now, but Karṇa has come. So, Karṇa will not spare them at all. Karṇa to aagaya na, definitely will kill Pandavas. Karṇa will not live. That is what the talk going on. So Sanjaya continued. In this way, all of them felt very happy and they went for the war. And Dronacharya, he arrayed all our forces, the Kaurava forces, in the shape of chariot, Shakata Vyuha. A cart, not chariot exactly, cart. Shakata Vyuha. And other side, Bhagavan Krishna and Arjuna, they stood in the front of their forces. Wonderful sloka is there. I will see that we will chant. Sanjaya says, Yodhanam Arjuna Sreshtah Gandivam Dhanusham Varam Vasudevascha Bhutanam Chakranam Chasudarshanam. He says so beautifully. Sanjaya says, Arjuna, Yodhanam Arjuna Sreshtah. Among all the warriors, Arjuna is the best. Gandivam Dhanusham Varam, and Gandiva bow is the best among all other bows. Vasudevascha Bhutanam, among all beings in the universe, who is the best Sreshta? Krishna Bhagavan. Chakranam cha Sudarshanam or Ayudhanam Sudarshanam. Sudarshana is the best, meaning all the four best things are with Pandavas. And they are together, Krishna and Arjuna, and Sudarshana Chakra and Gandhi. So he says so beautiful sloka. And so, on our side, Karṇa stood at front. When the war had started, all our forces have pounced upon Pandavas. Earth trembled with the echoing of the warriors' shouts. Dust rose in the sky. Shouts of the warriors all over the herd. And horses were neighing. All those shouts were heard. Filled in rage, the war started again between them. Ghora Yuddha again started on 11th day. And Dronacharya, he started troubling Pandavas and Somakas in no time using his divine weapons. Divyastra ka prayog karte karte, sabhi ko pani pilaya. Dronacharya. Dushtajumna came from that side, because Dushtajumna comes means Dronacharya slows down. He attacked in defense and he scattered all the forces of Dronacharya. And yahan pe Dronacharya went to other place again, started fighting, but people were unable to stand Drona's valor. All the Pandava forces and Somaka warriors ran away in different direction from the battlefield. Bahar jana, kuch der ke baad fir wapas aana. Pandavas. Meaning, not Arjuna and all, Pandava forces I am talking. Phir bhagte hain, phir aa jate hain. Phir bhagte hain, phir aa jate hain. That is what they were doing. And Drona was seen moving in the Pandava's army, in the battlefield, sorry, making rounds with his chariot like a firebrand. Alat Chakravat. So swift movements he was. And he was like a lunatic. Another place comes. Like a lunatic he was moving and killing all the Pandavas side forces left and right. He was destroying. So he became Pralayakala Rudra for Pandavas. Now, Sanjaya said, seeing Dronacharya destroying all the horses, elephants, chariots, and the Pandavas also could not stop him. Yudhishthira, dekha ye sab kya ho raha hai? Then he asked Arjuna and Dhrushtadyumna to go and stop him first. Then only our warriors, chief warriors, can go and attack. But Dronacharya is not allowing us to attack. There is no chance giving, he is not giving. First you stop him for some time at least. So Dronacharya was stopped by Arjuna and Dhrushtadyumna, and then afterwards, Sanjayji says, heroic deeds were performed by the sons of KK Rajkumaras, that is King of KKA, sons of King KKA, Rajya, Bhima, Abhimanyu, Ghatotkaja, Yudhishthira, Nakula, Sahadeva, warriors of Matsya Kingdom, all sons of Drupada, sons of Draupadi, Dushtaketu, Satyaki, Chekitana, Yujutsu, all of them got chance now attacked Kauravas. At that time, Drona looked very angrily, glanced his angry looks on the enemy forces which were protected by Arjuna and Bhima etc. in particular, and just as winds drive away the clouds, similarly Dronacharya apna bhayankar roop prakat karte hue, he started driving all the Pandava forces away. Sanjaya says, though he was old, but he was looking very young, and Dronacharya was running in all directions in the battlefield like a lunatic. Is a pagal bhagta hai na, vaise bhag raha hai. And he was killing spree, that's it, horses, elephant, chariot, jo samne aaya ghoomo har jagah, kill. And Dronacharya's horses were red in color, and because of the splashing of the blood of the killed warriors, the splashed blood also drenched his clothes also became wet, so he became red in color, horses were red, and his speed of the horses were like that of wind, and horses were very strong, that they were seen running without any rest. Sanjaya says here, bina thakavat lagatar daud rahe the, unki ghad. And looking at him, Pandava ran in different direction, Pandava forces, they would come back after some time, again they start fighting, and Sanjaya says, in this war, Dronacharya expressed his terrible form as a warrior, and he started killing, taking the names of the warriors by selection. Chun chun ke naam leke chun chun ke maar rahe the. And enemy soldiers got highly scared of his roars as well as the speed of his arrows. Not an ordinary man, Dronacharya also. So Dhrushtadyumna attacked in defense, and all that was happening, and thousands of arrows emerged from his bow, killing scores of enemies including horses, elephants and foot soldiers. Dronacharya attacked Yudhishthira forces, Bhimasena, Arjuna, Satyaki, etc. When because Yudhishthira and his forces were attacked, and all of them rushed towards Satyaki, Arjuna, Bhima to protect Yudhishthira and attacked him again. So Dronacharya in that war subdued Satyaki and Bhimasena, all others were subdued, and the forces in which Arjuna is in charge, sub battalion, no? Arjuna in charge, just keep the small force. For which Arjuna was in charge, in which Abhimanyu also was there, Drupada was there, all of the other warriors are there, even all other warriors where Arjuna was there, all of the Drupada, Abhimanyu themselves were subdued by Dronacharya. So, has subdued them all to bring victory to your sons. Sanjaya says, only to bring victory to your sons, Dronacharya was ferociously fighting. After displaying much valor in the war, and he performed many, many heroic deeds and burning the enemies in the war, Dronacharya left this world like the sun at the time of dissolution. Meaning, sun at the time of dissolution brings out more heat and burns all the worlds. Sunne marne se pehle bolte na, jyot bhi joda, vaisa hai. Sanjaya says, he did his best, shone in the war like a sun, pralayakala, Surya Bhagavan jaise, sabko taapte huve, sabko maarte huve, killing so many people, at last he succumbed and died. In this way, Dronacharya, after killing lakhs of enemy soldiers in the war, he got killed by Dhrushtadyumna in the end. He killed more than one Akshauhini of forces before his death and attained supreme state, that is Swarga. And he was ultimately killed by the Panchalas, that is Drupada, Dhrushtadyumna, etc., who are the performers of terrible deeds. Bhayankar karma karne wale jo Panchalas are there, they killed Dronacharya. The cries of the Kauravas were as well as invisible Bhutas, Bhutaganas, which are not seen, and also Kauravas' cry were heard after the death of Dronacharya. Purthvi par sare log ro rahe the, or invisible beings also started crying. The screams, they are heard everywhere. Ha! Fie upon this, meaning incident. Jaisa ghatna ko dikha rahe. They were heard from the beings of heaven, earth, intermediate locus, lokas, and also from all four quarters. Har jagah se suna, devatas, pitrus, as well as Dronacharya's ancestral brothers and relatives, those who died earlier, all of them saw Dronacharya's defeat and how he fell in the battlefield, how he was killed, were seen by all of them. And after the death of Dronacharya, Pandavas roared like lions after this, and the whole earth was resounding with their roars, Pandava roars. Thus Dronacharya also was killed. The news was brought. No flashback, Drona Parva. So Dronacharya khatam. Now Dhritarashtra uvacha, sun liya, Bhishmacharya ji ko suna. But then now he heard suddenly, after 4 or 5 days he came, mar gaya. What was Dronacharya doing in the war that time that he was killed so easily? Wo kya kar rahe the tab, Dhritarashtra ka prashna. But he was so easily attacked. He is an expert archer among all the other archers. Was his chariot broken? Batao na. Sanjay bolte bolte beech mein bomb dal diya. Jaise main dala ki nahi aapke upar abhi. Aap soch rahe the ki itna pura 2002 chapters ke baad marega. Aaj hi marwa diya. Mar gaye? Mar gaye. Just as you were surprised. Surprised hua ki nahi? Itne jaldi ho gaye? Drona par ho gaya. So Dhritarashtra also was shocked. Yuddha lad rahe the, mar gaya. Huh? Shock. Then he said, was his chariot broken? Or was his bow broke while fighting? Or was he not alert when enemies attacked him? Paradhyan mein kehte baith gaya. How did first of all death took place? He was always unconquerable to the enemies. He had great skill in his hands in warfare. He had many special abilities in warfare. How come Dushtajumna had killed Dronacharya? Same question. How come Shikhandi killed? Dekhte raho. Beta, dekhte raho. Pura sachanash ho jayega. It is now beyond a doubt, Sanjaya, that destiny is more powerful than Purusharth. Itna parakram, itne mehnat karke dikhane ke bawajood. So Sanjaya said, Sanjaya is continuing, Dhritarashtra. Oh Sanjaya, it is for sure that nobody dies in this world listening to the other's sorrows. Hai na? Dusron ka dukh sunte sunte koi marta kya koi? Koi nahi marega. Ulta kuch log chai peete rehte hai. Piyo. Suna main pee raha hoon. That is the nature of the world. मैंने कई बार ये उदाहरण दे चुका हूं, आप तो पसंद नहीं करते, फिर भी मैं बोल देता हूं. इवन somebody डेथ टेक प्लेस, डेड बॉडी इज देयर, रोने के लिए भी ताकत नहीं होती. बीच में दूध पीना, चाय पीना, कॉफी पीना, फिर रोते हैं. 24 यू हैव टू पानी पी लो, फिर रो लो. एंड द डेड बॉडी इज टेकन आउट, इमीडिएटली क्लीन्ड. बच्चे है, सब है, बूढ़े है, डायबिटिक लोग है, बीपी पेशेंट है, खाना पकता है कि नहीं? हाँ, बस. दैट इज द नेचर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. सो इट डजंट स्टॉप फॉर एनीबडी. सो देयरफॉर दिस इज द ट्रूथ. सो नोबडी डाइज, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम स्टिल अलाइव इवन आफ्टर लिसनिंग टू द डेथ ऑफ द्रोणाचार्य. माय फूलिश सन्स kept great hopes of winning the war with the help of Dronacharya. Dronacharya ko saath mein rakhte huye, un log soch liya ki humne, definitely we will, hum Pandavon ko maarenge, jeet payenge. And Dronacharya was equal to Brihaspati in intelligence, buddhi me, and equal to Shukracharya in Niti. How did he get killed? How was he killed? Kya Yudhishthira had surrounded him from all sides with his brothers and killed him? Aage se, peeche se. Other than Drushtajumna, who was under the protection of Arjuna always, no one else is capable of killing Dronacharya. Kaise mara gaya? He had knowledge of the Vedas. He practiced Brahmana Dharma, also Kshatriya Dharma, equally good. How did such an old Brahmin got killed? He says, filled with hatred in my heart, I always subjected Pandavas, the sons of Kunti, to various troubles, even though they don't deserve it. Ghruna ke karan man mein rakhte hue, I troubled Pandavas a lot. But Dronacharya silently bore all my bad behavior. Sara bartav jo tha Pandavon ke prati, silently bore. Today, his own karma, actions, gave him their fruits. What karma? Of silently bearing. Who says? Who Dhritarashtra says? Lagta hai ki, no, he never said no, anything to me. So those actions, karmas, of silently bearing, not telling me anything, I think that gave result to him today. All the bow men in the world, jitne bhi dhanurdhari log hai dunya mein, sabhi log, you know, in those days Dronacharya was considered as the Acharya, that's it. Nobody is capable. Great, great, great teacher, that's it. So thousands and thousands of people have learned how to use that bow and went away. Not only Kauravas and Pandavas. So all the bowmen in the world took support of Dronacharya, learned from him for their living. They became teachers, they became school, they started different places in the globe. He observed the bow of truthfulness. How was he killed? By those greedy people who are greedy after wealth, who Pandavas ko greedy keh rahe. Raj ke lobhi log, kaise maar diya unko? Lobhi ye hai, wo hai. Who were all those responsible people? Ye batao ki ek inka protection ka kaam do diya gaya tha. Unka naam batao. Who were all supposed to protect him? Who protected his wheels? Who protected right side, left side? From front, from back side? Batao ye saare chiz batao. It is said that one should put his best efforts in showing their valor in the war field, and Dronacharya did exactly the same thing. Ye saare chiz batao mujhe. Mujhe pareshan mat karo. Vaishampayana says, as he was questioning Sanjaya, Bada pooch rahe the na kya hua, kaisa hua, kya hua, lambi questions pooch rahe. I said, shorten them. Dhritarashtra, you know, dukh ka smaran karte 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 kya hota hai? Dukh badhta hai ki nahi? Kaise mara gaya? Kaise mara gaya? Kaise dukh ho gaya andar? Deep felt pain was felt very deeply in his heart. Afflicted by that pain in the heart, he fell unconscious. Murcho gaya. Bas. Oh, Raja, 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 sahab, sare servants aage. They sprinkled cold and fragrant waters. And all his women, his wives and all those people came, sat around him. And all his women slowly lifted him and made him sit on the throne. Simha bitha diya kursi par, simhasan par. He was unconscious. And after some time, slowly, he opened his eyes. And he opened his eyes, started. Who encountered Yudhishthira? Dukha ka anta nahi hota hai na. From our side, who encountered Yudhishthira? Who stopped Yudhishthira from advancing toward Dronacharya? Who stopped Bhima? Who stopped, means who fought with Nakula, Arjuna, from advancing towards Bhishma and Dronacharya? Who are all the people? Please tell me. Similarly, who stopped Abhimanyu on Pandava side? He was also a great warrior. What was the most difficult object to achieve for all those in the battlefield, which remained as an impossible task? What are the most difficult thing to achieve for our people in the battlefield and which remained as an impossible task? Tell me, what was that? How could, you know, defeat of Pandavas take place for whom Bhagavan Krishna himself is a supporter? Yes, Sanjay, to batao ki Bhagavan Krishna is supporting Pandavas. For Pandava, I vaise jaise Pandavon ko na prati jeet pana kaisa ho sakta hai? And Krishna is the guru of the whole world and is the most ancient master, Swami of all the worlds. He is Narayana himself, who offers protection to everybody in the battlefield. Sanjaya, Pandavas were there protected by Krishna. Who can encounter Krishna? Sanjaya, I shall now narrate to you the leelas of Bhagavan Krishna. Dekho, kaun keh rahe hai? Dhritarashtra. Leelas of Bhagavan Krishna, I will narrate to you, please listen. For my peace of mind. Swantas sukhaya tulasi raghunath gadha. To mere man ki shanti ke liye Bhagavan Krishna ki leela hai na, main aapko sunata hoon, jara suniye. Main kyun sunna hai? Main raja hoon. Suno. ये आज्ञा है. एंड जिनका यू नो कार्य एक्शंस वर ग्लोरिफाइड बाय ग्रेट मेन इन द वर्ल्ड. मैं अभी भगवान कृष्ण का स्मरण करूंगा, माने कृष्ण का इनका लीला का याद करते कराऊंगा आपको. मेरे मन की शांति के लिए आप जरा सुनते रहना. जैसे यू नो भगवान कृष्ण का याद करते सब लोग करते हैं. आई टेल यू, which aspect of Lord you invoke depend upon your state of mind at that time. Very important. So your invocation is always depending on your state of mind. Suppose a lot of body pains, bimariyan, Bhagavan, kab tak sharir ke saath main baithu, thoda theek kariye. So that moment my mind was identified with my body. Body theek hai, ghar pe sab pareshani hai, duniya mein pareshani, man mein shanti nahi hai. Bhagwan, sharir ka haath tod do, paar pair tod do, theek hai, man mein itna dukh kyon de raha ho? Your invocation will be from mind. Shanti data, shanti pradan karo. आरोग्यदाता, आरोग्य प्रदान, ऐसा नहीं कुछ. शांति दाता, मन की शांति. माइंड इज ओके, बॉडी इज ओके, बट इंटेलेक्ट इज ट्रबलिंग यू. बुद्धि कोई पढ़ते को समझ में नहीं आता है क्या है. देन और कंटेम्पलेशन और बुद्धि में प्रॉब्लम है. देन यू आस्क भगवान, आई एम अनेबल टू अंडरस्टैंड, मेक मी अंडरस्टैंड. व्हाट आवर बुद्धि, बुद्धि फंक्शंस, I am unable to discriminate, make me discriminate. Your prayer is always, or invocation is always from the state of your mind at that time. तब इसका देखिए, कृष्ण भगवान का सारा पराक्रम याद करते हैं आप शांति के लिए. See how Sanjay, now listen to the great deeds of Bhagavan Krishna. And whatever he did in his life, no one else could do them at any time. Sanjaya, during his childhood itself, when he was in Gokul, he had spread the glory of his strength and valor in all the three worlds. Hai na? Hai ki nahi? Putana se sanghar se suru hokar, so sekata so, so many. He killed and then apna bal ka parichay diya hai ki nahi? Right from Indra was shaken looking at this kid. And Bhagavan Krishna had killed a horse by name Keshi, which used to reside on the banks of Yamuna. And the horse was as powerful as the king of the horses, that is Uchchaishravas. Uchchaishravasam Ashwana. And similarly, he killed a terrible rakshasa in the form of a bull. Dhenukasura. Bullarka, whatever. Who joined the cowherd to kill Bhagavan Krishna. Then afterwards, he killed rakshasas, Pralambasura, Narakasura, Jambhasura, Pita, and also Mura. Pita, Mura, all those rakshasas were killed. He also killed Kamsa along with his aides, Kamsa's aides in the battlefield. Ranabhumi mein sabko mara. And Bhagavan Krishna, Balaram ji ke saath, he also killed the cousin of Kamsa, who was king of Shurasena by name Sunama, not Tsunami. Sunama. Bhagavan Krishna, along with his wife, he had worshipped, we saw the story, for many, many days, most angry Durvasa Muni. We saw the story. Durvasa Muni became guest to Bhagavan Krishna. Kya kya sataya Bhagavan Krishna ko aap? We have seen the Mahabharata. At the time, in the end, Durvasa Muni bestowed Bhagavan upon Krishna. Many boons he gave. And Bhagavan Krishna also won the daughter of a king of Gandhara Desha, in one of the kings of Gandhara Desha, in Swayamvar. And many kings who could not tolerate this attacked Krishna's chariot, and Bhagavan Krishna controlled all of them with his only whip in the hand. So, what happened? He got to kill them. He killed them all and ran away. And he injured them. Those are Bhagavan Krishna's leelas. And Bhagavan Krishna got Jarasandha killed in a dual fight with the help of Bhimasena through a technique. Upaya rachana karke maar diya Jarasandha ko. Bhagavan Krishna killed Shishupala like a pashu when he objected Agra Puja being offered to Bhagavan Krishna during Rajasuya Yaga of Yudhishthira. Bhagavan Krishna also killed a rakshasa by name Sauva. We saw Sauva standing in space. He fought with, conjured many Maya tricks and all. How Bhagavan Krishna also for a moment was received by Sauva, but he realized and then he killed him. Bhagavan Krishna attacked many kings and gained victory over Anga, Vanga, Kalinga, Magadha, Kashi, Kosala, Vatsa, Garga and Paunda Rajyas, kingdoms. He similarly, Bhagavan Krishna had defeated Avanti and southern Deshas, Dakshina Deshas, many Deshas, mountainous terrains in Himalayas and Desharka, Kashmir, Aurasika, Pishacha, Mudgala, Kamboja, Vatadhana, Chola, Pandya, Trigartha, Malava, Darada, all these kings were defeated by Bhagavan Krishna. In the past, Bhagavan Krishna entered into the oceanic waters and he fought with Varuna and he defeated him. Similarly, a Daitya by name Panchajana, who is a resident of Patala, was killed by Bhagavan Krishna and he got a conch by name Panchajanya. And during the Kandavadhanam, he satisfied Agnideva and got from him Agneyastra Chakra. Bhagavan Krishna, seated on Garuda, he went to Amaravati and he created fear in the residents of Amaravati, and thereafterwards he brought Parijata Vruksha from Mahendra Bhavan. Indra knew very well about Bhagavan Krishna, that's why he kept quiet without coming in confrontation with Krishna. And I never heard any name of the king who was not defeated by Krishna. Sanjaya, on the other day, what he showed in our court, a great wonder it was. Other than he, who else could do such things? I saw his Vishwarupa with utmost devotion on that day. Even today I remember all those things clearly. Sanjaya, it is not possible to know the end of Bhagavan Krishna's wisdom and valor. If Krishna calls Gada, Samba, Pradyumna, Viduratha, Agavaha, Aniruddha, Charudeshna, Sarana, Ulmuka, Nishatha, Jhilli, Bhabru, Pruthu, Viprutu, Shamika and Aramijaya. I think they are all sons of Bhagavan Krishna. Those and many other popular warriors from Yadavas, that is from Dwaraka, and he asked them to join Pandava's side. If they all of them join in the war, then all our efforts would become to an halt, come to an halt instantly. Sab khatam. Balarama is like Kailasha mountain in the war. He always remains where Bhagavan Krishna is. Sanjaya, will Krishna also join the fight for the sake of Pandavas? If Krishna gets ready for the war, apna kavach dharan karke, shastra uthake, then no one will stand in the battlefield willing to fight with him. If Kauravas conquer all the Pandavas, then Bhagavan Krishna would surely hold his weapon in the hands for their good. Suppose all Pandavas were killed, or Kauravas conquered all the Pandavas, do you think Bhagavan Krishna will keep quiet? He will hold his weapon and win all the Rajas and Kauravas in the battlefield, and Sara Bhumi kisko denge? Ya Kunti ko denge, ya Draupadi ko hath mein de denge. Do you think Krishna will keep quiet? So it is not a battle ended. Pandavas har gaya, to no, Bhagavan Krishna will fight. So, which chariot is capable of facing the chariot of Krishna in which Arjuna himself is a fighter? Nobody. So therefore, my dear Sanjaya, I am unable to see the victory of Kauravas in any way. Mai to dekh nahi sakta hu. Ek mar gaya to dusra niklega. Agar Krishna Bhagavan hai. And that is why, chalo theek hai, you tell me all the details as how did the war went on. Ab mai kya karun, Droṇa to mar gaya, vapas nahi la sakta hu. And anyway, Kauravas will not win now Pandavas. I think that is becoming clearer day by day. So Arjuna is Krishna's Atma and Bhagavan Krishna is Arjuna's Atma. See how beautiful it is said. So Arjuna is Krishna's Atma and Krishna is Arjuna's Atma, and victory, Jayam, always lives in Arjuna, and Krishna is the most ancient abode for fame. Kirti Krishna ke saath hamesha hai aur victory always resides in Arjuna. So vijay, victory and fame. So yatra partho dhanurdharah tatra shrihi vijayo bhutihi dhruvanetir matirmam. Beautiful. So Arjuna was never defeated in any war. Krishna has boundless qualities. Here we took only few qualities, humne smaran kiya unka. And Duryodhana doesn't understand that Bhagavan Krishna is none other than Satchidananda Ghanaswarupa. He was deluded and he was caught in the death snares. He doesn't know that Arjuna and Krishna are none other than Narayana Narayana. Their soul is one, their Atma is one, but they are appearing as two to the denizens of earth. Do jaise dikh rahe hai, actually wo ek hi hai. They cannot be conquered even mentally. Mentally you try, imagine Krishna killed and Arjuna killed, you can't. Man mein bhi you cannot conquer. If they both wish, they could destroy all my army in one moment. So Sanjaya, the fall of Bhishma and the death of Droṇa are indicating bad times. And this incident deprives the senses of all the beings of all the lokas. It is understood that no one can escape death by observing brahmacharya. Sun lena sab log. By study of Vedas or practicing karmas, and not by shooting arrows also. By shooting arrows, that is fighting with death, we cannot conquer death. Aap jitna bhi naak pakade, kaan pakade, jab murchukal aa gaya, bichara pranayam karte karte mar gaya. That the talk will be there, published. Purak kiya kumbhakan. Bahar gaya, andar nahi gaya. Achha, haan. Out. तो कुछ भी करो, जब मृत्युकाल आ गया, चलो जाएंगे सब लोग, so nothing will stop death. आप शीर्षासन करो या डाइट प्रैक्टिस करो, ये मतलब नहीं कि मैं सब बंद करना है, मैं ऐसा नहीं कह रहा हूँ, but don't expect longevity बढ़ेगी, ये सच्चा बेवकूफ लोग हैं, कुछ नहीं बढ़ेगा, देखिए, wonderful point, you will say something, let us see now. संजय, why should I live after listening to death news of Bhishma and Droṇa? In the past, we were very jealous of the wealth of Yudhishthira. And today, we got the fruits of that bad thinking or karma. It is only because of me that Kauravas are all on the verge of destruction. For those whose times have come to an end, dekhiye, jiska antakal aayi gaya, for them even a grain of sesame, a sesame seed lelo, that also would act like a vajra. Dude, ek sesame pek diya, but mar gaya.
कुछ नहीं खा रहे थे, बस कुछ अटक गया अंदर, वो बाहर कहा कि अकर लाने के लिए प्रयास करते 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 मर गए, अंदर क्या गया, बस रोज हम जो खाते वही खाते, बस गया क्या अंदर, पता नहीं अदरक की टुकड़ा. तो कब होगा मौत, नथिंग, अदरक की टुकड़ा गले में अटक गए और डॉक्टर के पास लेने से पहले ही मर गया बेचारा. बस सो मौत का कारण क्या है, अदरक. एटलीस्ट आई एम गिविंग अदरक की टुकड़ा, इसे सिसेमी सीड, वो भी वज्र बन के मौत. वंडरफुल. सो युधिष्ठिर बिकेम फिट टू एंजॉय. बोलते बेचारा बाथरूम जाए, हाँ स्लिप हुआ, हाँ कुछ नहीं हुआ, धीरे धीरे स्लाइडेड, हाँ बस वहां पीछे वॉश बेसिन के नीचे पाइप है ना, हाँ वो पाइप एग्जैक्ट पॉट में लगा, हाँ बोला पकक जला गया, खून नहीं निकला, नहीं निकला, सुझाव कुछ भी नहीं, कुछ बोला मौका क्या. दैट डेथ कम्स. सो डोंट इमेजिन, प्राणायाम कर रहे हैं, करते करते स्लैब गिर जाएगा आउट. अब मौत आया गया है तो वट एवर यू डू जो करना करते रहना अपने मन की शांति के लिए. अदर डॉक्टर विल टेल यू नॉट प्रैक्टिस प्राणायाम और नॉट प्रैक्टिस डाइट, यू नॉट प्रैक्टिस योगा, ना तो एक्सरसाइज नहीं किस लिए मर गया. वाई शुड ही टेल यू, वाई शुड गिव चांस टू डॉक्टर. योगासना कर रहे, रोज कर रहा हूं, अच्छा प्राणायाम खूब बड़ा बढ़िया करता, अच्छा डाइटिंग परफेक्ट, अच्छा एनी बैड हैबिट, नो बैड हैबिट, फिर क्या है, एक ही बैड हैबिट है क्या, दैट आई एम इनविंसिबल एंड आई विल नेवर डाई, दैट थॉट इज देयर. बस यही बीमारी है मेरे मन में, और कुछ नहीं है, ये बीमारी बहुत काफी है. चलो युधिष्ठिर बिकेम, Dhritarashtra says, Yudhishthira became fit to enjoy the wealth. Abhi now, to enjoy the wealth of whole samsara, he became fit now. And is alone anger, you know. Anger means, because dharma, dharma se jo nikalta hai na, that rosh, that bhavana, that caused the fall of Bhishma and Droṇa. So, Yudhishthira got the fruit of his dharma, but my sons are not getting the fruit of their dharma. इतना पुण्य किया है पर कुछ मिलता नहीं उनको. द क्रूयल एंड टेरेबल प्रेजेंट टाइम्स मेंट फॉर द डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ऑल इज नॉट पासिंग अवे. पता नहीं ये कष्टकाल कब खत्म होगा. संजय, इट इज माय एक्सपीरियंस दैट द विश विल्ड बाय मनस्वी लोग कंटेम्पलेटिव पीपल ऑल्सो गेट्स डाइवर्टेड बाय द इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ पावरफुल डेस्टिनी. दैव योग, मनस्वी लोगों का संकल्प भी काम नहीं आएगा. देयरफॉर यू टेल मी हाउ दिस अनवारंटेड बट ऑल्सो अनस्टॉपेबल इंसिडेंट टुक प्लेस, विच वॉज दैट फॉल ऑफ द्रोणाचार्य. देन संजय सेज, आई विल एक्सप्लेन टू यू इन डिटेल वॉट ऑल हैपेंड आफ्टर द वॉर बिगेन. That we will see tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Arihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Arihi Om Sadgurunath Maharaj Ki.